Hey, in this video, I'm going to show you how you can export your WhatsApp chats to a kind of database format that you can use on your computer to train LLMs, etc. This works if you have an Android device. I'm doing it on a Mac, but I believe you can do all this on a Windows or Linux computer as well. So first, I'm going to get over my phone and I'm going to go into WhatsApp. So in WhatsApp, I'm going to hit the three dots at the top and then settings. I'm going to scroll down to chats and then chat backup. And here what I'm going to do is I'll connect my Google account. So if you haven't, you'll need to connect your Google account there. And then I'm going to go this end-to-end encryption backup. I'm going to turn this on and then use 64-digit key and then generate this key. This is important. You can't use a password. You have to enable this end-to-end backup thing because otherwise you won't be able to see this encryption key and therefore you won't be able to decrypt your database. So what I'm going to do now is I can either screenshot it or I can select, press and hold on this and I can copy that just to make sure I have a record of that key. So I'll probably do both of those things just so we make sure we don't lose it. You can undo it if you don't have it, but it's just a faff if you lose it. So that's good. I've got it. I've saved it and I'm going to hit create. Now this will take a few minutes to kind of run through all your messages, create an archive, and so we'll wait about 2 or 3 minutes and then we'll be back in a bit. Okay, great. So it's spent some while processing. It also said it had to like prepare the backup. But once it's in this uploading stage, you don't actually need to wait for it to complete uploading because you don't need to upload it to Google Drive. We just need to get the files off the device. So this is fine. You don't need to stop the thing either. This is fine and we're good. What we'll then need to do is connect it to our computer so we can shift the files over to the computer to do that. So I can get the files, I'm going to go into settings. And then at the bottom, I'm going to go to about and then build number. And I'm going to tap that a bunch of times until it asks me for a PIN, or it might just say you are now a developer or something like this. So here I'm going to enter my PIN. Great. So now I've enabled developer mode on my phone, and this is going to allow me to connect to my computer and get the files off WhatsApp from it. If you already have developer mode enabled, you might not need to do that. Then I'm going to go to system and developer options. If you can't find this, you can usually use the search functionality in your system to either find the build number or the developer options panel. So developer options are now enabled. I'm going to go down to here where it says USB debugging. I'm just going to turn that on and then press OK. And next, I'm going to plug it into my computer. So I just plugged it in. There we go. And it's going to tell me USB debugging is enabled. And now I'm going to switch over to my computer. So over on my computer, I have this open. This is the Google Colab. I'll link this in the description below. But what I'm going to do here is we've done this thing where we've enabled a WhatsApp end-to-end encryption backup. We have enabled USB debugging on our phone. Next, we're going to install ADB. So on this Android debug bridge. On Mac, you can do this with Homebrew. If you already have Homebrew installed, you can run this. So that's the installation script. You open Terminal and you paste it in. So just to be clear, you can find Terminal in Spotlight. You can run the installation script. I'm not going to run that now because I already have it installed. And then you can run brew install cask Android platform tools to get ADB installed. And you run that again, and that works there because I've already got it installed, but it will install for you. If you're on Linux or Windows, there's instructions here on how you can download it. So you can hit this download file. It'll download all the package of tools, and then you can just run this ADB command directly. Great. And now if we just check ADB is installed, we can do ADB devices. And we can see, yeah, it responds and it says we've got this device attached. So this is all good. And now we're going to run these commands to actually copy the data over onto our computer. So I'm just going to move to a different folder just so it's cleaner. So I'm going to move into my downloads folder. I'm going to make a WhatsApp folder here. You don't have to do this. This is just, I'm putting it in my downloads folder. So it doesn't kind of class on my home folder, but that's fine. And then I'm going to copy paste these two files, these two commands in. You can see that it's done. That's a pretty quick procedure. What this is doing is copying all of the WhatsApp databases that are still encrypted from your device and onto your computer. So I've got those. Next, we're going to have to upload them to this Google Colab. So I'm going to run this Google Colab step by just hitting that play button there, and I can select my files. So I'm going to go into my downloads. I've found that WhatsApp demo folder, and here I want my databases, and then this message store has all the kind of like messages in it. The other one has things like your stickers or some attachments, etc. But we don't need that for now. So you can see it's going to upload. It'll take a little bit, and when that's done, I'll be back. Okay, great. So I've uploaded that file, that says 100% done, and it's saved to that file. What we can do now is we do this run decryption step. So I'm going to paste that encryption key we got earlier. So that's that 64-digit hexadecimal number. When in WhatsApp, there was that screen where we could copy it or we could take a screenshot. I'm going to paste that in here. And then I'm going to hit run on this step. There we go, it's done. It usually finishes very fast, so that just took 2 seconds. And then we should have the files on the left here. So if we go to files, you'll see we've got this message store.db. So the crypt is the encrypted version, the db version is the unencrypted version. So I'm just going to hit download to download that. And then that's all of my files, all my messages downloaded. Great. And now you can open this in any kind of tool that can open SQLite files. There's a free online SQLite viewer here if you want. But you know, you can use whatever you want. I'm going to file that, find that file. I've uploaded that file, and now I can see all the different kind of databases in there. The key one, I think, is called messages, or just message. So this one, so you see it's 168,000 rows, and it will include all your different kind of messages from your device. Great. And it also, if you want to work with this like in CSV format, you want to put it in like a Google Sheet or something like this, you can hit export and then all tables to CSV, or just the selected table to CSV. So I'm going to hit all tables to CSV. It'll take a minute because it is a lot of data in your WhatsApp files. So there we go. And then it's downloaded all of those tables. I can open this up. And you can see there are all the different tables from my WhatsApp. Great. So that's how you can access your WhatsApp data, pull it out and get it in a structured format. Thanks for watching and see you around.